Hello everybody, I'm Hannah, an English teacher at Virtually Fluent, and today we are going to learn the basic sports in English. This is tennis, and it is a very popular sport. To play tennis, you need two items. You need a tennis racket and a ball. You can play tennis with two or four players, so it is an interactive sport. To start a game of tennis, you throw the ball in the air and then hit it with your tennis racket. The ball must go over the net and then the other player hits the ball back to you. There are lots of rules in this game too. You must play inside the white lines of the court, and the ball can only bounce one time. It is a very fun sport to play. Another sport which is very similar to tennis is table tennis. This has the same rules. One player throws the ball in the air and hits it over the net, and the other player must return this. But everything is smaller and it's played on a table. The next sport is badminton, which is also played on a court. Instead of tennis rackets, these are called badminton rackets. You throw a shuttlecock into the air and hit it over the net. In this game, the shuttlecock cannot touch the floor. The final sport we will learn that is inside on a court is basketball. For basketball, you need a ball and a net. But this net is very high, and a player must throw the ball through the net to score points. The team with the biggest number of points at the end wins the game. This is a very interactive game with lots of players together. One player throws the ball and another player must catch the ball. It is a very tiring game too. The players run, jump, and hop around the court to score points. Now we are moving on to sports with balls, but outside. First is baseball, which is a typical American sport. One person throws a ball to a player, and the player must hit this ball very far. The player uses a bat to hit the ball. Next is one of the most popular sports, football. In the United States of America, this has a different name, soccer. To play football, players must kick the ball into a big net at the end of the pitch. Each time this happens, we say the player scores a goal. You often hear lots of people shouting "goal" when this happens. The team with the biggest number of goals at the end of the match wins. Our final sport with a ball is hockey. Hockey is very similar to football because players must score a goal in a net at the end of the pitch. But in hockey, you use a hockey stick to hit the ball, not your feet. Now let's learn some sports that use different equipment. We can ride a bike. For this sport, you need a bike. This is an outdoor sport that you can do in the garden or on the streets, and it's very healthy. We also have ice skating, where you need ice skates. Roller skating, where you need roller skates. And skateboarding, where you need a skateboard. We can also go fishing. You need lots of equipment for fishing, But the most important thing is the fishing rod. You throw this into the water and hopefully you catch a fish. Another sport in the water is sailing. For sailing, you need a boat and you move on the sea in this boat. Or there is swimming. For swimming, we need a swimming pool. When you finish swimming, you need to get dry, and for this, you need a towel. There are also some sports that don't need any equipment, like dancing, running, or walking. You can normally do these outside, or you can visit a sports centre to do these sports. So, we have learnt lots of new sports today. Do you do any of these sports? Let us know in the comments below.